Welcome to this lesson on estimating with percents. Today we're going to look at how to look at a percentage and be able to estimate what that value would be. So for example, if you're at a store and you're going to purchase a shirt that's 40% off and the original price is $18.50, how can you quickly figure out the sale price on this? And no, the answer is not pull out your cell phone and use your calculator. So when you're finding 10% of something, or you know, we talk about like 10%, 100%, think about the fact that you're multiplying or dividing. So I'm going to make myself a little box here so we can have some space to work. Okay, so if I'm taking 10% of 100, I know that that means that I'm taking 0 and 10 hundredths times 100. We'll also look at it this way. Can we say that we're taking 10 hundredths times 100, which would also be the same thing as saying 1/10 times 100. And we've always said that when you're taking something, so we know that if we're taking 100 times 1/10, it's the same thing as saying 100 divided by 10. So really what you're doing when you're taking 10% of something, you're taking it and you're dividing it by 10. Okay, now this only works with powers of 10, so don't think that that's how it works with 10, 20, or with 20, 30, 40, 50, whatever. That's only how it works with the powers of 10, so 10, 100, 1,000, so on and so forth. And we know that when we divide by 10, you take your decimal, which is here, and you move it one place to the left. Well, that's the exact same thing that you do when you're taking a percent of something. So if I want 10% of 100, I take the decimal and I move it one place to the left. So I know that 10% of 100 is 10. Now think about 1%. 1% is like saying 1%, and I know that that's equal to 1/100. So if I take 1/100 times 100, isn't that just going to give me, so if I cross simplify, 1? So when I do that, when I want 1% of something, because of the fact that I'm actually, so if I take this and I can also say that it's dividing it by 100, so if I have 100 and I divide it by 100, that gives me 1. So when I'm finding 1% of something, so 1% of 100, you're taking that decimal and you're moving it twice to the left. So I know that that is 1. Okay, so really it's a simple rule of 10% once left, 1% twice to the left. Now, what about 5%? So let's think logically when it comes to 5%. I got a little bit of a box left here. So 5% is half of 10%. So if 10% of 100 is 10, shouldn't 5% be half of that? So you would take that 10 and divide it by 2 and you get 5%. Or you could take 1% and add it 5 times, but this seems a little bit more doable and quick. Okay, so again, when you're finding 10%, you move the decimal once to the left, and that's 10%. When you're finding 1%, you move the decimal twice to the left, and that's 1%. When you're looking for 5%, that's going to be half of your 10%. So let's use this logic when we look at other problems. So we're going to find, we have 18.50, and we're going to find 1%, 10%, 5%, 15, 20, 50, 100, 150, 200. Okay, because remember, if you have 100%, you can also go above, I mean, you always have 100%, but you can also always go above 100%. Just because that's all of it doesn't mean you can't have more than all of it. So for 1%, I take 18.50 and I move my decimal twice to the left. So 1% of $18.50 is 0 185 thousandths. Since we're talking about money, we would say that that is 19 cents because we would round. For 10%, we would take 1850 and we would take that decimal and move it once to the left because we're dividing it by 10. And we would get, $1.85. And we don't have to do any rounding because it's already ending in the hundredths place. Because remember, we can just take that zero off the end. So 5%. For 5%, I would take 185 because that's 10%, and I would divide it by 2. So I know that 2 goes into 18 9 times. And it goes into 5, 2 times, and it goes into 10, 5 times. So then we can also double check here with our calculator, $1.85 divided by 2 gives me 0 925 thousandths. But in this case, because it's money, we round it and say 0 93 hundredths. So with money, you have to round it, but if you're just finding 5% and it's not money, you should go all the way out to the thousandths or however far you need to go. So now for 15%, you have to look at the pieces that you can put together. So 15 is 10 plus 5. So we can take our 10%, which was $1.85, add our 5%, which was 93 cents, and we would get 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 9 is 17, carry the 1, $2.78. Now, again, it's estimating, so these are all approximate. For 20%, you have 10 times 2, so you can take your 10% and double it. Okay. So I have the 10% and I'm going to double it. So 185 times 2, 2 times 5 is 10, carry the 1, 8 times 2 is 16, plus 1 is 7, carry the 1, 1 times 2 is 2, plus 1 is 3, so 20% would be $3.70. Now 50%, yes, you can sit and you can add a bunch up and get to 50%, or what you could do is you could say 50% is the 10% times 5, or you could say that it's half of 1850, so you can take half of your number, which then I know would be, so half of 1850, which I know would be half of 18 is 9 and half of 50 is 25, so $9.25, or you can take your 5% and multiply it by 10. So if you take your 5% and times it by 10, then all you're doing is moving the decimal once to the left. So you're taking 0 925 thousandths times 10, once to the right, and you got $9.25. So you have a couple of options here. But if this is an even number, just take half of it because 50% is half of 100, so 50% is always your half. 100% is the easiest one of all. It's just 1850 because it's all of it. 150% is going to be your 100 plus your 50. So take your 1850 plus your 925. 5 plus 0 is 5, 2 plus 5 is 7, 9 plus 8 is 17, carry the 1. So 150% or 150% is $27.75. Notice it's more than the 1850. 200% then would just be your 100% times 2, or take your 20% and multiply it by 10. Because then all you're doing is moving your decimal one place to the right. So you're taking 370 times 10, move that decimal one place to the right, and you get $37. Or again, take 1850 plus 1850. 0 and 0 is 0, 5 and 5 is 10, carry the 1, 8 and 8 is 16, plus 1 is 7, carry the 1, 1, 2, 3, 37, same thing. Okay, so again, it's all about moving the decimals and then understanding that you can use your other estimated pieces. And we can look at, what if they gave us asses for 11%? Well, we would take our 10% plus 1%, so we would take 19 cents plus $1.85. 5 plus 9 is 14, carry the 1. 8 plus 2 is 10, carry the 1. So it'd be $2.04. Right? As always, I have problems at the end that I would like you to try on your own. And make sure that you're showing that you're moving your decimal, or that you're taking 10% and multiplying it by 2, because you are going to have to show, if I were doing this in my head, what would I be doing? So again, if you're doing 20%, you could say, ooh, I'm just taking my 10% times 2. If you're doing 50%, you could just write half of total. You know, whatever you need to do to show that, hey, that's what I'm doing in my head. All right? As always, if you have any questions, please be sure to write them down or email me so we can go over them in class.